I love doing what I do, whether it be for the News and Record here in Greensboro, or our state magazine, or whatever writing endeavor that I kind of jump on, for the simple reason it kind of gives you a passport. It gives you a passport to see the world. And also, if you do it, if you work hard at it, and I've been doing this for 25 years, it affords you the opportunity to kind of show readers, you know, who we are as a country, who we are as a state, who we are as a community, and who we are as people. And I think it's important. I mean, writers, we kind of get down the first draft of history. And also, when you look at our state's one of the, is like the National Geographic of North Carolina. When you open it up, it shows you pictures and through words, as well as the website, you know, who we are as a state. Where are we at this exact moment? It's one of these kind of magazines that you find on tables and in attics for years to come. You know, they pull it out like a favorite, you know, keepsake, like a yearbook, and they kind of open up the pages and it's all that, ah, yeah, they're pretty pictures and they're pretty stories. But also, it's these stories enrich us. And we can learn from this, particularly here in North Carolina. We're at a time in our state, you know, where we're going to be growing, you know, and we're going to have a lot of new folks coming in from all over the place. And this magazine, our state, is a window in what we should be take pride in our state. You know, what makes us who we are, what makes us, you know, laugh. What makes us smile? What makes us come here because we want to breathe the air in this state? That's what you get from our state. And as a writer, if you can do it right and you work hard at that, that's what people can get. Because that magazine, our state, that National Geographic of North Carolina, is a passport they'll keep for years to come. I always tell folks, whether beginning writers or college journalists who I work with, think of your stories, think of yourself as a movie director. And what you need to do is you need to think of each of your story as scenes. And you want to recreate those scenes. And you want to write with all your senses. What do you see? What do you hear? What do you smell? And you write that from various vantage points and you make it come alive. Because there's no such thing as, it's just, writing doesn't have to be boring. But there are boring writers. But if you dig into the grist of who we are and the emotions of it all, and then you kind of recreate that on the page, it's not stale. It's something that is timeless, and you can see that through literature, whether it be Charles Dickens, to journalism and newspapers, or what you see in our state magazine. It can come alive, and it's important because it tells us who we are and how we live. Whatever story you're writing, you want to think about a structure and the framework, and then in that structure and your framework is you find these characters, you know, you bring them on stage and you get them off, you know, and then what you want to do is kind of let these characters, these people in your stories show you about what's important to them. What inspires me is write when I can show people something they never knew existed, or they never knew that was there. What inspires me to write is where I see stories that can make a difference. Throughout time, we've used stories to learn about one another. You know, how we function in the world, how we get along in the world. And I think when I find stories like that, that show a bigger theme of who we are as people, you know, then that's where the richness lies. I always kind of look at it like a painting, or maybe even better, a piece of sculpture. You chisel away, you chisel away, you chisel away, and you work on it for, you know, days, weeks, months. And then you kind of step away from it and go, ha. And then there's always a point where you want to put it down in terms of the whole writing process. You want to walk away from it. And it can be for 5 minutes or for 5 days or however, because you want that piece to breathe and you want to come back to it with a fresh set of eyes. And I always say that every story has to have a rhythm. It has to have, you want to read it out loud, and it has to have a pace. And the funny thing is when I was an editor for the News and Record in Rockingham County, the writers I had always made fun of me because I would always play Miles Davis's Kind of Blue all the time in the office. And they would always come in and they would kind of be doing that syncopation from Kind of Blue, particularly Miles Davis' song All Blues, because it's that syncopation, that dun chicka dun ka dun chicka dun ka dun chicka dun ka dun. Well, I think stories have to have that. They have to all have that sense of rhythm. You know, like Alan McBeal used to say, oh, she had her favorite song. Well, every song, I mean, you want to have a favorite song with the stories that you write because you have to hear it. Every story has to have that syncopation, has to have that rhythm. And when I hear All Blues in my head, when I read my stories out loud, and I can hear Miles Davis in my head, I know I'm close. I know I'm all right.